feisty, feisty.
Here with the great Bernard Hopkins. Bernard, talk to us a little about this great fight coming up on Saturday, Ryan versus Fortuna.
It's one of those fights I think it's great for the test moment that we want to see. And you know who need to be tested. It's more Ryan's obligation to show that he's ready for anybody up there, including, as you heard, Tank Davis or anybody else. But I think that when you look at Ryan's last fight, what have he learned and did not learn from that fight to what's going to happen Saturday? So it's still a question mark that's there. But Saturday, I believe that it's up to him, Ryan, to be able to say, I'm going through this door, and this is who I want. And personally, I believe he's going to do that. And I think that you and everybody else are going to be asking for the Tank Davis fight.
Is that a fight?
I really believe that.
As a fighter, I know you just said it's a question mark or something that Ryan still has to answer. The lightweight division is stacked. Is that a person you want to see him fight Tank, or is it somebody else in the lightweight division that you would like?
No, I'd rather see him go right to the top. Tank right now is the division. I'll say it again if you need me to repeat it. Why mess with the second or the third best? Go right to the dance. I mean, if you really believe that you are that guy, then you have to be that guy, but not talk that guy.
And I gotta ask you, because a lot of people gonna, you know, go off on that.
People do what people do. But what's gonna happen is what's gonna happen, but you gotta understand that everything has a process, whether I like it or anybody else like it. The process starts Saturday. And it leads to, we know, without having, hopefully, to bigger and better things for Ryan Garcia.
Devin Haney has all the belts.
So? So? You can have all the belts, but that don't mean they all fit your pants. Who's more popular, Ryan or Haney? Who's more popular? You mean to tell me Haney walk in the mall anywhere downtown LA, they're going to, well, take out LA, because it's anywhere else. Who's going to see who first? I mean, it is what it is. It ain't about color, it ain't about tall, it ain't about who looks better. It's about the talent. That's what I see. And again, that division, the top five, the top four, wait, it's good. It's good. It's a lot of good fights gonna happen here. And listen, I see a whole mixture of good fights happening in that division. I'm just telling you, when Ryan make that statement Saturday, go right for the top of the top of that. Why mess around down there to prove it's already been proven? And listen, if you can't prove it yourself that night, when that happened, just win now, after Saturday, then I think that everything else is irrelevant. Like, what are we talking about? He wants to go for the top. I admire that, especially when he has the momentum to go right to the top. And we approve that he's ready, but can't approve whether he's going to win or lose or not until it happens. But right now, we got to get through that step of that door right there. That door is important. Because even though we can disagree to agree, he got through that door. Anyone else, it seems, will be non-productive.
It went from 0 to 200, exchanging hats, smiling, to like, I'm the boogeyman, I'm the boogeyman.
That was for y'all.
It was entertaining, it was good.
That was pretty fly. That was pretty fly. But that's one thing about boxing that no other sport other than, well, there's wrestling, there's other sports that has UFC. Yeah, but we the only sport in combat that I think, you know what I mean, that can sell at and have people feeling some kind of way, good or bad. But at the end of the day, we all know that we're going to talk about it until the fight happens, which is in a couple of days.
A little different than you taking a flag and throwing it, knowing that you had.
Don King has something to do with that too. Don King has something to do with that. That flag went down for a lot of reasons. I don't know if the ticket sales is kind of low. I don't know if it's the morale of the Puerto Ricans is kind of low. But a little birdie came and tweaked in my ear.
Hey, what you got for more?
Right now, we're 48 hours away. That's it.
Yeah, going to count. We're going to count down for things to come bigger and better. This is a countdown for a legacy in that division. For multiple fights to happen in that division. Super fights. So I can't. I'm trying to condition myself. Like this is the step. What comes after this is super fights in that division. I'm talking to Ray Leonard, the 80 era, man, come on. The early 90 era.
The four kings.
Yes, the four kings. That's what we're looking at, the four kings of this era. The four kings of this era is shaping up and gaining some momentum. And Saturday night it'd be full blown.
Looking good.
Fortuna
was in shape. I didn't know what to expect.
Both of them in shape.
He didn't take off his sweatshirt. I thought maybe he had a reason, but he
didn't. Camouflage.
Yeah,
he's good. He's always in shape. Look, I never seen a man out of shape.
Two-time champion.
I never seen a man out of shape.